Trump and Melania host military families at the White House for their first July 4th as President and First Lady, but not before another trip to the golf course. Donald Trump hosted military families at the White House for his first July 4th as President, but not before he took yet another trip to the golf course. The President, who wished a happy 4th to everyone, earlier on Tuesday, tweeted that he was getting ready to celebrate the 4th of July with a big crowd at the White House. Our country will grow and prosper. Trump and Melania, wearing a long blue and white dress, later appeared on the Truman Balcony at the White House where the 71-year-old praised the contribution of servicemen and women. "Each of you here today represents that rare combination of patriotism, virtue and courage," he told the crowd. "At this moment your brothers and sisters in arms are posted around the globe, fighting our enemies and standing watch to protect our nation. They are fighting for us. We are thanking them, praying for them and saluting them for their selfless sacrifice." Trump pledged his unwavering support, promising them and their families he would always have your back. He also commented on the luck of having such pleasant weather for the event, which will be followed by a fireworks viewing event for military families and staffers. The fireworks celebration on the National Mall is a large-scale event that attracts people from across the country to see the sparks fly in the nation's capital. "The rain stopped just as we came out," he added. "I don't know what that means, but it's not bad." Earlier that day, the president had been spotted at his golf club in Virginia, his 36th day at a golf course as president. It's also his 50th visit to a Trump-owned venue since taking office and has spent many a weekend at his Mar-a-Lago luxury resort in West Palm Beach and golf clubs in Virginia and New Jersey. First daughter and special counselor Ivanka Trump also spoke out about her pride in Americans and her appreciation for the country. "I am proud on so many levels, and really traveling this country has made me even more of a proud American today than at any other point in my life," she said in an interview with Fox News on Tuesday. "You see the spirit, the tenacity. You see the sacrifice. You meet with soldiers and sailors and their families, and you think about all the things that they're doing to ensure that the America we know remains true and can continue on," Trump continued. Melania also wished everyone a happy Independence Day on Twitter, adding, "We are the land of the free because of the brave. Thank you to the heroes who serve. Thank you to the U.S. Navy Country Current and U.S. Army Downrange Bands for performing at tonight's picnic to honor the military. #Happy4TH. Donald Trump Jr. also posted a picture of himself in a star-spangled t-shirt saying, "Always awesome to see companies not afraid to show their patriotic side. Thanks to my friend at Jason Hairston and at @KuiU_official for doing just that. #MAGA. Meanwhile, Vice President Mike Pence was seen waving to parade goers during his visit to the annual Granville 4th of July celebration on Wilson Avenue in Granville, Michigan earlier today, before he flew back to Washington, D.C. to be by Trump's side for the July 4th address. Former President George W. Bush and his wife Laura also wished everyone a happy July 4th in an Instagram post. "Laura and I wish our fellow Americans a happy Independence Day and thank those who serve and sacrifice to defend the freedoms we celebrate today," he wrote. Americans across the world are celebrating their country's birthday Tuesday with big-time fireworks, small-town parades and the quirky spectacle of competitive hot dog eating, marking a day of shared traditions in a nation that has grappled with divides this past year. In New York, throngs attended the annual Macy's Fireworks Blowout and the Nathan's famous Frankfurter Chomping Contest on Coney Island on July 4. In Boston, one of 14 original copies of the Declaration of Independence will be displayed at a museum, and hundreds of thousands of people are expected at the city's fireworks show. Organizers of Chicago's Independence Day celebration are expecting such large crowds that the city's Navy Pier is opening at 10 a.m. nearly 12 hours before fireworks begin. Meanwhile, more than 15,000 new citizens will be sworn in during more than 65 Independence Day-themed naturalization ceremonies across the country. And on the other side of the world, Americans were showing off their patriotic colors to mark the special day. At a U.S. base in Poland, American sailors held an open day for visitors and were seen handing out flags and posing with locals to celebrate Independence Day. While their compatriots celebrated, U.S. Senator Elizabeth Warren was at work at the Resolute Support headquarters in Kabul, Afghanistan, where she gave a speech at a press conference. U.S. Senator John McCain was also in attendance after visiting the NATO-led mission's headquarters on July 4, a day after leading a U.S. Senate delegation to meet Pakistan's Prime Minister Nawaz Sharif in Islamabad to discuss regional security. For all the pomp and celebration, July 4 arrives with Americans deeply split over the nation's direction, after last year's presidential election and political clashes over immigration, healthcare and other issues in the early months of Trump's Republican administration. And in an era of concerns about security, the Independence Day celebrations are mixed with precautions. The New York Police Department plans to station 100 vehicles to block intersections and 20 sand-filled sanitation trucks to fortify viewing areas for the Macy's fireworks show. Heavily armed counterterrorism units will mingle among spectators. Officers will have portable radiation detection devices and bomb-sniffing dogs, and officers will be stationed on rooftops to look out for any sign of trouble. Boston police also plan to put trucks and other heavy equipment near the celebration there. Police in both cities say there are no confirmed threats. In a somber observance of the toll of terror, small American flags will be placed by all the nearly 3,000 names on the National September 11 Memorial in New York. Meanwhile, residents of